We welcome you to the Cathedral of St. John the Evangelist. A special welcome to all our visitors and guests. For those of you who are searching for a home church, please consider becoming a part of our cathedral family. Today we celebrate the Solemnity of All Saints Day. The collection will be for the general fund. The All Souls Day Mass will be in the cathedral this year at 5:30 p.m. All are invited to bring your family and share in this rich tradition. At this time, you are reminded to please silence all cell phones. Today, the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass is being offered for Maxim Mac Bernard, Bush and Webb families, Mr. and Mrs. Scranton A. Mouton, Curtis Launche, Ms. Zula Rayo, Doris D. Fayila, Laverne Bork Robin Quibido families, Joseph Stevens and Bondi families, Mr. and Mrs. Roy Giott Sr., Mr. and Mrs. Lewis Carl Keel Jr., families of A. Dennis Landry, G. A. Rodemaker, and Remy Landry, Como and Savoie families, Blanchette, Como, and Gerois families, Bertha and Gerald Abshire Sr., John and Dot Montesano, Charles, Cecile, David, and Chuck Walker, K. J. Helen and Mary Domingue, Dean Broussard, Melba and Loomis Gugus, Marguerite and Sam Kennedy, Michael A. Ackles Sr., Elias Elias, Elaine Thomas, Melvin R. Bosch, Dr. Frem F. Bustani Jr., Beatrice Bustani, Frem F. Bustani Sr., Jesse Luquette, Mr. and Mrs. Joseph A. Domingue, Ms. Cecile Goulas, Mr. and Mrs. Louis A. Domingue, Ms. Mary H. George, Scatola, Cascio, and Bergreen families, Whitney, Lucille Mouton, and deceased children, Launche and DeLome families, Calice J. Landry Jr., Jerry Tozin, Bro Broussard and LeBlanc Jordan families, William Rowe, Mr. and Mrs. L.A. Berger, Mr. and Mrs. Van Harry Sr., Van Cleve Harry III, Diana Lee Gesser, Benny Andrus, Rebecca Bragg Marcantel, Dr. Zerbin and Gertrude Biavenue, Margaret A. Mouton, Scranton A. Mouton Jr., Rosalind E. Hebert, Edgar Sonny Mouton, Effie Marie Moss Como, Charles Rishu, A.J. Antoine, Rose Begnaud, Dot Dupuy, Carl Hebert, members of the R. W. Howard and R. H. Little families, Jacqueline Boulany, Philip Jude Orgeron, Anna Mary Dischler, Chris Christensen, Gail Ann Addison, Charles A. Miller, Alton Olivier, Thomas Vadreen and Teeny Miller, Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Huval, George and Edith Maynard, Peggy Huval, Lionel Russell, Leroy Bourgeois, Richard Chasson, Raul, Mary, and Sidney Castile Sr., Celeste and Gradney Herpin, Newland D. Hebert. Our opening hymn for today is found in the hymnal number 336. That's number 336 for all the saints. Please join in prayer with our celebrant, Bishop Douglas Deshotel, as we stand.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
Peace be with you. My brothers and sisters, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, to be nourished with the Word of God in the sacred scriptures, and the body and blood of the Lord in the Holy Eucharist, let us first call to mind our sins and failings, asking the good Lord for his healing and forgiveness in our lives. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw another angel come up from the east, holding the seal of the living God. He cried out in a loud voice to the four angels who were given power to damage the land and the sea. Do not damage the land or the sea or the trees until we put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God. I heard the number of those who had been marked with the seal, 144,000 marked from every tribe of the Israelites. After this, I had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation comes from our God, who is seated on the throne and from the Lamb." All the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They prostrated themselves before the throne, worshiped God, and exclaimed, "Amen, blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor, power, and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders spoke up and said to me, "Who are these wearing white robes, and where did they come from?" I said to him, "My Lord, you are the one who knows." He said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
The Lord's are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord, or who may stand in his holy place? One whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob.
Lord, this is the people that longs to see your face.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know Him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like Him, for we shall see Him as He is. Everyone who has this hope based on Him makes himself pure as He is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We gather today as a Christian community, along with Christians all over the world, to celebrate this feast of All Saints. The Church sets aside every year this day. It's a holy day of obligation for us as Catholics to commemorate this feast day of all the saints, to honor those men and women of all the ages of the Church, who, as we heard in the reading from the book of Revelation, washed their robes white in the blood of the Lamb. These are the men and women who have been faithful to Christ throughout their lives. The Church honors them because they reflect in their holy lives aspects of God Himself. In all of the holy martyrs, the great teachers and doctors, those who exhibited heroic charity in caring for their neighbor, all of those saints who followed Christ to the end of their lives are honored by the church today, and in turn, we honor God Himself who made this possible. The church also celebrates the Feast of All Saints to remind us that each and every one of us, all who are baptized into the body of Christ, are called to be saints. The church celebrates this feast day to present to us models of Christian living, to imitate the saints in our daily lives as followers of Christ. Sometimes we have the mistaken notion that the saints had it easier than we do to be holy, that somehow they were exempt from all of the trials and difficulties that we go through as human beings, and so they had an easier go of it in being holy in their lives and in imitating Christ. And this is not true. The saints were human beings just as we are, with all of the limitations, with all of the difficulties, with all of the challenges that we go through each day in whatever walk of life that we are in. The church honors these because they remained faithful through it all, and shows us how we can remain faithful despite going through anything in our lives. Some of the saints were very young. Some of the saints were very old. Some of the saints were married people. Some of them were single people. Some of the saints were priests or sisters. Some of them were even bishops. And they still remained faithful throughout all of their lives to Christ. Some of them were even great sinners. And yet, because they were open to the forgiveness and healing of the Lamb of God, became great saints and showed us how we too are called to be saints. Our celebration of this feast day and that of tomorrow when we celebrate the Feast of All Souls is a reminder to us of another great teaching of our Catholic faith, and that is that teaching on the communion of all saints. That is, that all of us who are baptized into the body of Christ belong to that great family of God, the saints in heaven, we here on earth during our pilgrimage to heaven, and also the holy souls who are awaiting their final entrance into heaven, all belong to that body of Christ, so much so that we can pray for each other. We can ask the saints in heaven to show us their holy lives that we might imitate them. We can ask them to intercede for us on our behalf to God. Just think of asking a patron saint or a favorite saint of yours to pray on your behalf, to ask God that He give you the grace that you need to be as faithful to Christ as that saint was in their lives. Sometimes our praying to the saints is misunderstood as being adoring the saints or worshiping false gods. Of course, this is not true. We're asking the saints who are close to God, who are now holy and free from all the cares of this life, to intercede on our behalf, to ask for the graces that we need in this life. How many of us, when we were little kids, went up to our grandmother or to a holy aunt or uncle that we knew and asked them to pray for us because we were having some difficulty in our lives? I remember asking my grandmother, because I knew she was holy, to pray for me so that I could pass a test sometimes. We intercede with our brothers and sisters in heaven, asking them, now that they are freed from the cares of this life, And they know our particular crosses that we have to carry in this life, to pray for us, that we have the grace to be faithful in imitating Christ to the end of our lives as they were. As we honor the saints today, we honor Almighty God. And we also reflect upon the truth that we are, in the end, but pilgrims through this life. That earth is not our true and final home, but that each of us are called to an eternal destiny in the life of God, just as the saints whom we honor today. God bless you all in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us stand as together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, what consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. In the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I acknowledge baptism for and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. God's love has raised to glory those who were faithful unto death and given them an everlasting share in his holiness. Let us offer our petitions by responding, "Hear our prayers, O Lord, through all the saints."
That God grant our Holy Father, Pope Francis, compassion and care to live the gospel in love and service to all people, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayers, O Lord, through all the saints.
That all who honor the saints today may be inspired to imitate their faith and compassion, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayers, O Lord, through all the saints.
That all those buried in our cemetery may now enjoy the vision of God forever, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayers, O Lord, through all the saints.
That all who have served and are serving in the armed forces will know the gratitude of all Americans, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayers, O Lord, through all the saints.
That God may reward with everlasting life all who show goodness to us, and that he may grant eternal rest to all who have died in the faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayers, O Lord, through all the saints. God of love, our strength and protection, hear the prayers of your church. Grant that when we come to you in faith, our prayers may be answered. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, that will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity, and cleanse me from all my sins. Thank you, guys. Let us stand and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that, just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality, so we may experience their concern for our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our Mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already gives you eternal praise. Towards her we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the Church, through whom you give us, in our frailty, both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with the multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and glorify.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Douglas our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by the word of by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace of the Lord be with you. Peace, Chester. Thank you. Peace be with you, George, and with your spirit. Peace of the Lord be with you, Patrick's spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. May the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. The body of Christ.
The blood of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Body of Christ. Amen.
body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. Body of Christ. O holy banquet in which Christ has received the memory of his passion is renewed, the soul is filled with grace, and there is given to us the pledge of future glory. You have given them bread from heaven, having all sweetness with you. Let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your saints, we implore your grace so that, coming to perfect holiness in the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of our heavenly home, through Christ our Lord. Thank you.
After the final blessing, I invite you to join us on our plaza here of the cathedral. We will be having the blessing of our cemetery immediately following the Mass. Also, there is the novena to Our Lady of Perpetual Help that will also be said in the church. So we invite you to please join us on the plaza if you can. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Our
help is in the name of the Lord.
May
Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.